This interpolated surface in the 3D view shows some steep discontinuities where extensional fault planes have offset the horizon. Using the control panel, I can show some of those fault planes to see the fault horizon relationship more clearly. Switching to the map view, it would be nice to see a similar display showing where the fault and horizon intersect. Under display settings, it is possible to show the intersections of the fault plane with the current horizontal slice value. Scrolling through the time slices shows the top of the fault at around 600 milliseconds. As the slice deepens, the intersection migrates down dip until the base of the fault at around 2600 milliseconds. The horizon has multiple Z values, and so when using this technique, the fault may or may not be intersecting the horizon at any given location. Changing the display to horizon intersections shows exactly where the fault crosses the horizon. Now the structural map and segments are aligned. Another method of showing the steep fault plane is to use contours. A large interval of 20 milliseconds shows roughly where the faults are. Making the interval smaller to 10 and then 5 milliseconds has the effect of darkening the fault plane. Attributes from the horizon or the volume could also be used since most faults introduce a discontinuity that is easily detected. This surface works particularly well with the dip curvature horizon attribute, which is great as it is a standard attribute calculated on the fly. Putting the contours back on superimposes three different methods of visualizing the fault and horizon intersection. Interestingly, what was originally interpreted as a single long fault can now clearly be seen as four or more separate faults connected with relay ramps. Fault polygons can be used to capture an interpretation of this visualization of the intersection. In the Control Panel, Polygons tab, create a new fault polygon. Provide a name. Optionally, associate the polygon to a horizon, from where it will extract the Z value. If you forgot to associate a horizon, you can select or change your horizon at any time after creation. Change the color and thickness to maximize visibility on your unique display. Click the pencil to begin interpretation, adding points with mouse button 1. Move away from the polygon and right-click to end that shape. Click mouse button 1 to begin a new shape. My colleague has informed me that they have interpreted the rest of the polygons already. I just need to load them into the session. If the new polygons are associated to the same horizon as the first set, they can be combined together. Highlight both polygon sets, right-click, and select Combine as New Polygon. Type a new name. Assign the suitable color, thickness, and associate the polygons to a Z value or horizon. Existing polygons can be edited by clicking the pencil, then using mouse button 1 to drag a node to a better position. Right-click finishes that edit or deletes a node. Right-click within a polygon allows me to delete that entire shape. Polygon fill using the right choice of color gives the polygons a slick finish. Fault polygons can be used in many processes to exclude interpretation. For example, the erase operation can be applied to the original time horizon to clear the interpolated horizon values. The cleaned horizon looks excellent in the 3D view. If you have questions or would like to discover more, then visit our website at www.dog.com. And remember, have fun with InSight!